Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now am found. Was blind, but now I see. Was grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fear relieved. How precious did that grace appear, the
safe thus far, and grace will lead me home.
The Lord has promised good to me, His word my hope secures. As long as life endures,
when we've been there 10,000 years, bright shining as the sun, we've no less days to sing God's praise than when we first begun.
Then when we first begun.
When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot, Thou hast taught
Family, thank you for being here today. To Linda's, we're not going to call it a funeral service, a graduation service, promotion service, victory service, celebration service. There's a lot of things we could call it because of the life that Linda lived. But this is a day of grieving and also a day of joy at the same time. And we'll have an opportunity to talk all about that. So thank you for being here. Let's bow our heads for a word of prayer. Father, we believe you are the God of comfort. And so we ask for that this morning. We know that you are the God of peace, and we ask for an extra amount of peace today, and especially for the family, that this would honor Linda's life, and that this would bring some healing for them and in the weeks and months to come. Thank you for the gift of life in that we get to share it together, and we got to see your glory revealed in Linda's life because she lived it for you. Thank you for all the family and friends who are here today to honor her as well. I ask that you bless this service. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. A couple of passages that I would like to read. John chapter 14, these are the words of Jesus. Do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. My Father's house has many rooms. If that were not so, would I have told you that I am going there to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me, that you also may be where I am. You know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we don't know where you are going, so how can we know the way? In verse 6, Jesus answered, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. And then in Psalm 23, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He refreshes my soul. He guides me along paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. Linda Sue Ramp was promoted to her heavenly home on April 6, 2022, at the age of 83. She was born in Valparaiso, Indiana, where she met and married her husband of 60 years, Bill. They started their married life together in Virginia, where Bill served in the Air Force and her daughters were born there. From there, they went to New York and then moved to Houston, where she had the full-time career as a domestic engineer. After raising her girls, she and Bill moved to San Ramon, California. After retirement, they moved to Katy, Texas. Linda enjoyed spending time with her grandchildren, line dancing, puzzles, and crafting. She played the flute, piano, and organ, and was a member of the One Accord musical group in Katy for over 20 years. She enjoyed going to church, attending home Bible studies, and volunteering at different church activities. She loved to crochet and gifted hundreds of blankets she made over the years. She is survived by her husband, Bill Ramp, brother Pete, spouse Betty, Paul, daughters Carrie Stook and Tammy, spouse Rick Gresham, grandchildren Rachel, Ben, Danielle, spouse Benjamin, Chris, Lydia, and Josh, and extended family. Linda was preceded in death by her mother Marjorie, spouse Charlie Smith, and father Lester, spouse Betty Paul, and sister Debbie, spouse Eric Hagen. One of her favorite songs was In the Garden, and Bill would like us to sing this together. So would you stand and let's sing these wonderful words. Seated. Daughter Carrie would like to share a few words at this time. You know what? I don't know if that's on. It's not on. Let me help you. It's on now.
Yeah. Hello, everyone. I am Carrie. I'm Linda's daughter, also known as the one in California. On behalf of our family, we'd all like to welcome you and thank you so much for coming to help celebrate and honor the life of my mom, Linda. You might know her as Linda, Grandma, Aunt Linda, Lindy, or Mrs. Bill. Linda was born in Valparaiso, Indiana in 1938 to Les and Marjorie. She was younger sister to Pete. Her father had a music store and her mother taught piano and organ. She had a talent for playing the piano, organ, and flute, and music would always be a big part of her life. In fact, Linda met her husband Bill when he moved to her hometown to attend Valparaiso University, and she heard him playing in, now catch his name, the Bob Fiasco Trio. They married and were in Virginia, where Bill was in the Air Force, and then they were on Long Island for a short time, and then moved to Houston, where Bill worked for Texaco, and Linda was a domestic engineer. An added bonus to moving to Houston was that Linda's extended family was here. Linda enjoyed raising her daughters and was a brownie leader, church secretary and organist, maker of cookies, fudge, and rampola, which was our family's special version of homemade granola. She volunteered at Faith West Church's resale shop in Katy when it first started. She liked to sew and made us matching dresses and was even a member of the Craft of the Month Club. Her painting of the Lord's Supper that you saw when you came in was always on display at our house. She loved making crafts, and I remember her making them out of the punch cards from my dad's work. Anybody know what a punch card is? A little fold and staple here, some gold spray paint and glitter, and voila, a Christmas wreath. She enjoyed crocheting and would end up making hundreds of blankets over the years, each time saying, "This is the last one I make." But of course, she continued to make more. You've probably seen some of those on display here at the church today. Some of you may have been the lucky recipients of these lovingly made blankets. Anyone have one? Yeah? My personal favorite is the one that she gave me when my son was born. I was late coming to the mom party, and she made it years ahead of time in the hope and anticipation of his arrival. So my child would be sure to have one just in case she wasn't making a really warm. She and Bill moved to Northern California after us girls left the nest. My husband and I also moved to the area. They made the most of their time there, going on day trips on the weekends to Monterey, San Francisco, Muir Woods. We met up with a regular group for Friday night dinners, and they spent lots of time fellowshipping with friends from church where they served as greeters. She picked up the name Mrs. Bill here from their polite and younger English friend Martin, who thought Mrs. Rev was too formal, but Linda was a little too informal and not respectful enough, so he came up with Mrs. Bill. And that name stuck. California is also where they started to line dance, which my mother loved. My sister Tammy was back in Katy, and her husband Rick and their children Rachel, Ben, Danielle, and Chris. My parents would drive back and forth from California to Katy, or for sure at the time, Patterson, to see them. And they would drive straight through to Texas. It's like 26 hours. I still don't know how they did that. I really don't. After Bill retired, they moved back to the Katy area just in time for Tammy's daughter, Lydia, to be born. Linda loved being grandma and spending time doing things with her grandchildren. She took them to the pool, on bike rides, to the park. She and Bill hosted Sunday lunch for the family every week. When it was too quiet at her own house, she'd have Bill drive her over to Tammy's, where she could be in the middle of all the activity with all his friends. We would visit from California, spending a couple weeks at a time at Grandma's house. She and Bill continued to line dance in Katy, walk the mall, and they joined the choir, singing at nursing homes in the Katy area. She was in the choir for over 20 years, singing, playing the flute, doing the occasional line dance, and she and Bill booked all of their engagements. She loved being part of the group. So do we have any fellow line dancers or one quarters here? Thank you all so much for coming, and thank you for being part of her life. Now, some moms love jewelry and purses. Our mom loves stuffed animals and just about any tchotchke that was cute and miniature size. She loved Bucky's and Bucky's t-shirts. She had quite the collection. And jigsaw puzzles. She did them with all of her grandchildren. She loved to be out and about. When we were in high school, we would often wake up on Saturday mornings to a note on the whiteboard that they had gone out garage sale looking. She also loved long sunny drives. When we lived in Ailey years ago, we used to drive all the way out to the boondocks to Katy, and we'd stop for a hot fudge sundae at Dairy Queen before the long trip back home. My mom loved hot fudge sundaes, as long as they were enough. She was blessed to be married to her best friend and devoted husband for over 60 years, Bill, who took wonderful care of her over the years, and especially these last few. He was to see her just about every day for several hours, feed her lunch. He's just the example of a loving and dedicated husband. We thank you, God. Mom showed us what it means to serve through her many volunteer roles at church all throughout her life. She had a strong faith in Jesus. She was part of countless Bible studies over the years. She especially loved fellowshipping and visiting with friends. In the last few years of her life, this became more and more difficult for her because she had a hard time talking. And this was hard on her and those of us who love her. We know now in heaven that she's enjoying talking just as much as she wants to, and she's laughing and smiling with her Savior.
Amen. Good job. Rick, it's your turn. Son-in-law, he's going to sing a song called Face to Face, one that he wrote himself, and he's going to do it a cappella.
Though as if through a haze is covered with the morning dew. All I saw was a shadow of your glory, but I knew it was you. Face to face, face to face, I knew one day I would be. Face to face with my Lord and my God, face to face we would be.
Is there anybody else who would like to say a few words before we continue? Good deal. Anybody else? I'm going to ask you, even if you don't want to come up here and speak, would you think of an attribute of Linda that you appreciated, or a story that makes you laugh, or something about her that you are really grateful for, and would you turn to the person next to you and just share that with them for the next few moments? Just share that attribute about Linda with the person next to you. All right. I said one attribute, just one. But that's what I thought would happen. A lot of smiles and laughing, and I'm not surprised. Blessed are those who die in the Lord. They will find rest from their labor, and their deeds will follow them. Linda's death is a loss for us, but from God's vantage point, it's a blessing, because Linda has found rest in her Lord, and her deeds are following her. Ecclesiastes chapter 3 says, "For everything there is a season, a time for every activity under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to harvest, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to tear down and a time to build up, a time to cry and a time to laugh, a time to grieve and a time to dance." That last verse, a time to cry and a time to laugh. Rarely does that happen at the same time, but I think that's today. We're mourning and laughing, a time to grieve and a time to dance. And ironically with you guys, both could be true. Many of you know the story of Job in the Bible, had a lot of ups and downs in his life. Linda had a lot of good times too, and she had some tough times. Not to the point of Job, but I like the last verse in the book of Job. Have you ever noticed it? Chapter 42, verse 17, last line that gives a description of his life. "And so he died, old and full of years." I don't think that "full of years" is a term that meant how many years in his life. I think it was about how much life was in his years. And I think we could put that phrase to Linda. She died full of years. She lived a full life. So I want to put one word in our minds today. When I think of Linda, that's the word family. I'm thinking of several different families that she had. Let me explain. She had her earthly family. Married to Bill for 60 years. Wow. Don't you think we ought to put our hands together just for a moment in today's day and age? I love the term that Bill uses, domestic engineer. Man, I like that, and I'm going to be stealing it, just so you know. And I bet she was. Linda was a lot of things, but she was first and foremost a wife and a mother, grandmother. So I want to say something to the family. God knows you're tired right now, and he knows you're hurting. And Psalm 91 says, "He will command his angels concerning you." Let him be your strength today, and he will. Psalm 34 says, "God is near to the brokenhearted." He is extra near to you today. So she had a relationship with her earthly family. She also had a relationship with a whole bunch of other families. You say, what other families? Well, all of you. Look at this room. When they told me she was extroverted, I was like, yeah, I'd say. All the different things she was into, crocheting, puzzles, exercising, small things, trinkets, stuffed animals, cookies, all these different things. And Carrie did a good job earlier, kind of stole my thunder for a moment, but I'm gonna ask you, if you had a connection to Linda through One Accord, will you stand up just for a moment? And I just want you to see this. Stand up. Thank you. My goodness. This is part of her family. This is part of her family. Thank you for being here. Some of you will remain standing, because if you had a connection with her through line dancing, will you stand up? Any line dancers out there? Bill, I don't know why you're not standing up right now. I just saw a video of you. That was pretty good. Thank you for being here as well. Wow. My guess is there's more family units out there than what I even know just by listening to her life. So she had a connection with her earthly family, all those other families. She had a relationship with her church family. She was devoted to her church, played the organ, church secretary, Bible studies. The Bible consistently makes the point, if you have a relationship with Jesus, you will have a relationship with his bride. And she did. 1 John chapter 1, verse 3 says, "We proclaim to you what we have seen and heard, so that you also may have fellowship with us. And our fellowship together is with the Father and with his Son, Jesus Christ. And she had that. But I want to spend the most of my time on her last family, her relationship with her eternal family. One of the questions that gets asked a lot is, where is Linda now? Or where is the person who passed away? Where is she right now? And the Bible gives an answer to that. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 8, to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. You call it what you want, the holy city, the new Jerusalem, paradise, Abraham's bosom, heaven, whatever you want to call it, doesn't matter. She's with Jesus. To be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord, which means the last breath she took here was her first breath in the arms of Jesus Christ. She is with her eternal family. That's why Paul said Christians grieve, but Christians grieve differently. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 says, "Dear brothers and sisters, we want you to know what will happen to the believers who have died, so that you will not grieve like people who have no hope." It doesn't negate the pain, and it doesn't negate the grieving. He just says we do it differently. And he tells us why in verse 14, "For we believe that Jesus died and rose again," and Linda did. "So we also believe that God will bring with Jesus those who have fallen asleep in him." Isn't that a cool phrase? Fallen asleep. The early Christians didn't call it death, didn't call it passing away, giving up the ghost, kicking the bucket, wrong side of the grass. They called it falling asleep, hence temporary. Temporary. This is temporary. This pain is temporary. This departure is temporary. And I just imagine Matthew chapter 8, verse 11 is happening right now. "I say to you that many will come from the east and the west, and we will sit down with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob in the kingdom of God." That isn't fairy tale language. That's true. She might be sitting down with Abraham right now and asking him, "How was it to drop off a baby in the nursery when you were 100 years old? Did you get some looks?" Maybe that's the conversation she's having. I don't know. Maybe she's talking with Eve right now. "Did you ever want to knock Adam upside the head? What was his pickup line to you? You're the only one for me?" Well, yeah, probably. Maybe she's talking with King David right now. "Did you have a backup plan if you missed with the stone on Goliath?" Or maybe she's teaching line dancing to Jonah right now as we speak. I don't know, but she's with her eternal family. Jesus was one time challenged on this. Some of his friends said, "Hey, your mother and brothers and sisters are over there." And he stopped them and said, "You want to know who my family is?" And he looked at his disciples and said, "Those who do the will of my heavenly Father, that's my family." And we can all be a part of that family today. So I want to say a few things. First one to Bill. Well done, man. Really, well done. You know why we're sitting in this room right now? Because we're a few hundred feet away from another room where you were every day. We were trying to get together for coffee. We couldn't get it. We finally got it, but it was tough for me to get something in the schedule because he always had a meeting with Linda. Well done. You kept your vows. Till death do us part. You will never regret that. And we don't know all that you did, but good job. And to the family, this is not the final page of the story that God has written for you. C.S. Lewis, in his classic story, The Chronicles of Narnia, put it this way at the end. "The things that began to happen after that were so great and beautiful that I cannot write them. And for us, this is the end of all stories, and we can most truly say that they all lived happily ever after. But for them, it was only the beginning of the real story. All their life in this world had only been the cover and the title page. And now at last, they were beginning chapter one of the greatest story which no one on earth has read, which goes on forever and ever, in which every chapter is better than the one before." When our life on earth is done, and Jesus will someday return, time will no longer work against us, it will work for us. I had a banana the other day and it had a brown spot on it. Fruit will never rot someday. Flowers will never lose their petals. They will be more beautiful the next day than they were before. All relationships and conversations will be even better the next day than they were before. And so after visiting with the family about a week ago, they walked out of this building and I sat down, grabbed a pen, and wrote one line of how I could recap Linda's life. And here's the line. I hope it's right. When describing Linda, what a source of great joy for so many people. Is that right? What a source of great joy for so many people. That's a great legacy to leave behind. Amen? That's a great legacy to leave behind. Watching all the people walk in here today coming together teaches me that Linda's life was a source of great joy for others for 83 years. And Linda gave us a final gift. She gave us the gift of knowing where she is right now because Jesus was her Lord and Savior. There's no better gift to give. So let me close with this. Linda Ramp was a good woman, but Linda was a sinner, like all of us. And the reason we're here today is because she put her faith and trust in Jesus Christ. For all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. But God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish but have everlasting life. For though we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, we will fear no evil, for he is with me. Therefore we do not lose heart. Though outwardly we are wasting away, inwardly we are being renewed day by day. For our light and momentary troubles are achieving for us an eternal glory that far outweighs them all. And so we fix our eyes not on what is seen, but on what is unseen. For what is seen is temporary, but what is unseen is eternal. For if this earthly tent that we live in is destroyed, we have a building not made by human hands, but built by God. If this were not true, wouldn't I have told you? Because I go to prepare a place for you, you can come to be with me as well. Blessed is Linda, who died in the Lord. She is resting from her labor, and her deeds will forever follow her. Let's pray. Father, thank you for the gift that was Linda Ramp. Thank you that she was a light on a hill that could not be darkened in this cursed world. Thank you for the example that she was and that we can try to emulate today. And maybe even today, some of us have been faced with the reality that we aren't ready for this moment, but she was. I pray that we all walk out of here ready to give the gift to our family of knowing where we are. Thank you for Jesus. Thank you for the hope that we have in him. Thank you for the peace that surpasses all understanding. And thank you that he went to the cross to die for all of our sins and that we can join him in his resurrection just like Linda already has. I pray your comfort upon the family. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Thank you for being here today. The family wants to invite you to a 5-course meal of Chick-fil-A catered in by Chick-fil-A. It's going to be right out there. There's going to be some people moving chairs around and getting this ready, but you're all invited to stay. I hope you take a few moments and visit with each other and visit with the family. I'm going to ask you guys to stay on the front row. Can you do that as you guys come forward and visit with them? Thank you for being here today.
I want to personally thank you for watching Linda Sue Ramp's celebration of life service that took place at Venture Christian Church, Katy, Texas, on April 23rd, 2022. God bless you.